Hello, my friends, and it's time for another episode of The Chest of Obscurity. And this time we're looking at a very, very obscure PS2 game, which we never got out of. We never got out here, and it's only been, say, a Europe-only release. Anime is saved just for this reason. So, what are we going to be looking at today? This is the October season for this particular selection. Strangely, I felt inspired after watching Castlevania Resurrection, the Dreamcast E3 demo on the Long Play channel. This is called Project Altered Beast, or in Europe, Altered Beast. It's brought to us by Sega of 2005. So, of course, since we're going into this, we have our subtitles, so we're going to keep those on. And vibration, I think. Yeah, you got vibration. So, we're just gonna go into it. I also remember playing Golden Axed, which was a parody of something of a trash game. Not a trash game, it was a trashed game done by Sega. Because the last time we ever had a proper Golden Axe game. I'm not going to say Beast Rider, because I don't know what the fuck Beast Rider really was. But the last good Golden Axe game were the ones on the arcade. I mean, if really want to come down to it, the last few Golden Axe games that we ever had were on the following: the Master System, the PC Engine, the Sega Genesis, and the arcade. And there was one for the Xbox 360, but it wasn't as good as hoped. So, we have story mode. We can't do anything else other than say play through a story to get everything else, which is the beast data, the enemy data, the boss time attack, whatever that is, and the gallery. So let's go into it. Let's see what's really going on with the story.
Listen to this guy. Why isn't he flying over this place then?
Geez, you said it.
Still, what the hell are we doing out here?
Your job.
And what the hell is in that damn box? They got us flying over toxic freaking fumes. And for what?
emergency pizza delivery.
One could only wish.
Huh? What the hell was that?
And yet the box is still standing. From your grave. The story takes place in modern Greece. So, to display the map, we press R1 like so. We have five areas, just like with the old school Altered Beast, which the game had, you know, five areas. I doubt that it plays out the same way. So, our character here has a regular punch, a charge punch. He can jump. That's about it. L1 is to adjust the camera. We all know what we know what R1 does, which is bring up the map. Select this pause. It's awfully weird because it is what it is. Press square button.
Geno. Chip. Huh?
Yeah, this is modern Altered Beast. Oh, now it brings us close. So this is a werewolf, as you can tell. As you can tell, the controls are as follows. Square is my claw attack, X is my jump attack, triangle is my berserker rage. And I can only pull it off unless my rage meter has built, so I can pull off a special attack. And I said this earlier when I was looking at the Castlevania Resurrection video. I said, you know, given the fact that A, if it was given such a chance as, say, patching was concerned and, you know, a bit more, you know, bug fixing and whatnot, then yes, I believe it would have been something. So yeah, that's supposed to happen.
The beast is taking over your mind. You're going to die unless we do something.
Like with Breath of Fire. The later games, anyway.
What's happening to me? Who are you?
You don't remember? Don't worry, it's just a tranquilizer. Transformation puts quite a bit of stress on your cerebral cortex.
No kidding.
That's the human part of your brain. We don't want your mind to transform as
transform.
Well, do we?
Transform? What are you talking about?
I don't suppose you would have the chips with you like you're supposed to. Though, I doubt that in your current state, you even know what I'm talking about.
Wait! Damn.
You can now revert to human form with the help of tranquilizers. While in beast form, you consume spirit energy, defeat enemies, and absorb their spirit energy. Killing blow. You can absorb spirit energy directly from enemies once they have been weakened sufficiently. So, a gut punch. So it's almost like with, it's almost like with Onimusha in a way. Oh god, this looks so wrong. Like, what is he doing to his... I mean, you look at it look like he's jerking him off in some way. It's like, go deep! Transform. Circle is for transform. You will start to lose life if you stay in beast form after you run out of spirit energy. So, unlike with the older version of Alter Beast, this one is more... You can't stay in this form for so long. You only have, like, a limited time to be in beast mode. I mean, like I said, it's totally different. What you're really doing is, you're doing what you did in the original, which is power up. So that was your, so the Ichigeki or the killing blow is basically your way of doing the power up. Set of stairs beyond the rubble. Go the area you want. You can't alter if you need to. What I find interesting about this game is that, for one, it takes the whole legend differently. You know, like they did with Shinobi. They turned it into... They turned it into something more like, okay, So I take it what I would have to do is become a wolf, tear down the rubble with my wolf power, and go from there. Nice concept at the time. I don't see why I was ever brought over here. And that's the one thing I just didn't like about Sega. It never took the plunge. It's like there are certain things I liked about certain companies. Like, for one, we look at, say, working designs. What I liked about them? They brought over games like Lunar and Vi, and even Exile over here. Oh, and let's not forget Potful Mill. And even they brought over Landgreaser, otherwise known as Warsong, over here. But the problem with what they did was they made the games, when they ported it over here, a little bit too strong for its own good, because, you know, it's like you're playing a game that have levels that were 5 levels higher than you. Like, what the fuck? So you would have 3 genomes in order to do the following. It's somewhat like the Musou series, you know. You have a certain button combination you input just to make these kind of attacks. Like I said, I saw nothing wrong with this except for the fact that that's good. You can actually change at will. That's different than the original Ultra Beast didn't do. You could change back at will, so you can revert back into human form, or press a button, or basically, you know, you can basically go into your wolf form, but the wolf form takes health the longer you're in it. Thank you. time, just like the original, you can change to different beasts. I really would like to know, how do I get past this? Give me a moment. I'm gonna actually look this up. Okay, so... what I would have to do is... graveyard. Now there are, at least from what I read, there are like 5 areas but 14 levels. Why this was canceled beyond me is anyone's guess. This guy's name is Luke, and he was sent as an operative to take care of an investigation. We've seen this trope before, haven't we, guys? This is a finished game, it just never got off the ground over here in the States. And as I said, it was a Europe-only release. Now you can use gene manipulation can only be performed while in human. I'm not into the spooky type games. I rather just kill shit. You know? If it's gonna be dark, no. Let me kill shit. You're technically doing a sonic attack.
Chucky!
You know, given the circumstances of how this game works, it would have worked just fine had it been ported over to the S. It was a completed game. Why it was canceled upon release beyond anyone's guess. And like I said, the one thing I just didn't like about Sega is that they never took the initiative to this day. They still don't.
Kill him enough times just to do that.
The rush attack has a use, you know, to basically break. Break guards. To the catacombs. It's straightforward, to the point. Of course, you have to battle your way through.
Hmm.
each bit of the place you're going through. I mean, the only cheat I would put in is for infinite life. The only downside I see through all this is there's no way you can get health back. Or if there is, I am teaming. It also reminds me of Wolf Child. If anybody else remember that old game? Sir, if you have health, I desire your blood. Obscurity, I need your blood. All of a sudden, this happens. Oh, by the way, that looks like a boss. But in order to get there, we would have to go deeper. At least in the case of this, your beast mode is actually like a utility of sorts that actually works for you. I suppose the red is the one for your health, and the green is for you. It's for your spirit. Yeah, it does make sense. And are we dead? Yeah, okay. The DNA strands are for enemy data. Had this affinity about, you know, don't give me more. The least you're actually going to do for me in horror is just like, either I'm not going to sleep, talk to you like a dog. I say it would have worked out, really. If it was brought over here, it would have worked out. So this is really a modern, this is how you do a modern take of an old classic. You keep the story, but change it up a bit. Oh, you got health. I'll take your health. First thing I would do is take care of the air first. Using the jump, basically, is to cover more ground. Companies nowadays, they they do take the plunge and they don't. And at the same time, I'm just wondering, like, especially during this age, this time. You know, especially during the pandemic. Oh, I hate you motherfuckers. Never did like rats. Annoying as hell, just like roaches. Try killing one. Oh, a couple more coming out of the woodwork. Didn't mean to do that. Where's the Rat King at? Can't say it again. Really? Can't say it again while I'm beast form, huh? Mind you,
that's easy.
But the good thing is, whenever you show up at a save point, it heals you just like that. Rat King. I was looking for you.
Chucky!
Like the spin dash will just do wonders on him, just wreck his whole shit up.
Yeah.
game is basically saying, hey, you need to stay in beast form. Sir. At least they're nice enough to leave me little droplets of health. You don't really see that much happening with things like these, like, oh, we're gonna give you a spy chance. Literally had to sideswipe them. Of course, it's just one life and game over. Let's just try that again, shall we? This way we have enemy data after we... After we gotten, you know, a bit of story and whatnot. So, of course, there are 14 bosses, 83, I suppose, standard enemies, and 25 unique enemies. This is the gatekeeper. No, this is a living corpse. The giant rat. The bat. Glad to know this. I kind of see that, you know, the hitbox is quite spotty at best. the one thing you would have to do, as far as that was concerned, you would have to go on the side of him. I noticed you can't hit that, you can't hit him spot on. You gotta go for that underbelly. There we go. It's dead. Like I said, that's a spotty hitbox at best. Wish they really had was the theme song, an updated version of the theme song. That would have been nice. Charming, isn't it? The eye is glowing.
I assume you've already been debriefed on the situation in Forehead Town. I need you to investigate the research facility and confirm the fate of Dr. Eric Jobs and his research team. Sorry, but you're on your own on this one. You're the only one who can survive in that genome mist. It's
Seeing as you are still highly classified, you will be transported under secrecy. As for the chips you will be carrying with you, feel free to administer them using your own discretion. Remember, we haven't tested the effects of administering all the chips simultaneously, so don't get too trigger happy.
Therefore, Merman, which hasn't been brought in Alter Base since God knows how, because they did exist in the second stage in the original Alter Base. Oh, that bubble bomb's useful. One thing they did get right is how to move in water. You know, very effectively. That's one problem that most games these days never mastered and never got pat down. Is when you're in water, it's manipulation. That actually makes sense, really. What I don't like about this is, well, as you tell, after you finish a boss, you should be able to save after that. At least the enemy spam has a purpose. I see what I gotta do. I gotta hold it down. And just, you know, hold it down to a 7. Where my base data. In this case, you know, you could run past the enemies, but it's not really it's in your best interest to just fight him. Because even if they spawn... That's actually smart. Like hell, you can make your own moves. The more you grind, the more it will pay off. And it does make sense. So it takes you back to the crash site. Okay. Takes you to the forest. This takes you to a safe point. So you know what? I think this is a good stopping point for this video because I feel this is something that should have came out over here. Because you don't get this kind of exploration in a game like this, especially if it's quote unquote horror. Especially what you can do here, and the safe spots being so sparse, but it's like sparse to a point where you can actually stop right there, heal, And plus, oh, the healing part with the save, you don't really get to see that very often, but when you do, it is worth it. So, with that said, I think I've covered this game long enough to constitute the fact that for those who have never heard of this, well, now you have. So that will do it for me for this October edition of the Chest of Obscurity. Once again, I am PI7, your friendly neighborhood Tenkaichi, and this was a look at Project Altered Beast for the PlayStation 2, brought to us by Sega of 2005. I'll see you next time for more of the Chest of Obscurity. Thanks so much for watching.